Good counters early from Zamboanga. That's what she's going to be looking to doing. She's going to be looking to take those kicks, deflect, and then counter right back with that right hand. There it is again.
Big shot early on from Zamboanga on a straight right. Oh, they're going. Oh,
there's that right hand.
Wow.
Nice little touch to the chin right there. Drop Lin Heqin.
Heqin got dropped, but back to her feet here. An exciting opening 30 seconds and another straight right from Zamboanga.
There's that spinning back kick that we spoke about on the walk from Lin Heqin, but she's got to time that a little bit better. She's got to set that up. Denice is finding a home with that right hand as she's closing that distance. Boom, again.
Three straight rights early on by Zamboanga. She went for another takedown here, and they go back in toe-to-toe in the one circle.
Yeah, you can tell that Denice has been working on her striking for this match because those punches are coming in much straighter than she's typically been in the past. Right down the pipe, she's catching Lin Heqin off guard with this.
Well, when you move your camp to the Philippines, you know your hands are going to be sharp. She actually moved her camp to her brother's gym, who is actually in her corner, who fights later on at 164. So that's what Lin needs to do. She needs to start touching her with those legs, find that reach, get comfortable in there. I think she's a little bit rattled by that right hand that keeps landing.
Yeah, I think at this point, Lin needs to completely change the game plan here, start looking for a clinch or something, because Denice has a beat on her timing completely. Lin's not even coming close with the right hand.
You can see some damage on the face early on here from Heqin. Round number one, another straight right to the face, and another, and then Zamboanga got caught on the way in. So they take it to the canvas.
Wow.
Firing lefts. Heqin has got top position here as she goes to work really for the first time. Zamboanga back to her feet. Heqin against the fence. What a start. What a crowd. Just past 9 a.m. local time, and they are 100% behind Zamboanga, the number three contender.
Good recovery by Zamboanga, but what a turnaround for Lin Heqin. This is where Zamboanga really starts to excel, is up against this wall. She's got a lot of pressure, and she's able to pin people and just immobilize them up against that cage wall.
Yeah, but we saw Lin Heqin against Suzuki Hirata in this position for a good portion of the fight, and Hirata had trouble getting her to the ground.
Zamboanga with the uppercut on the way out. Back to the center of the one circle. Nearing the midpoint of this opening round of three, again, the bout judged as a whole.
See, Lin Heqin's starting to parry with her lead hand, and the way that Zamboanga's coming over the top with it, she's able to find that distance and really touch her every time with it. Lin Heqin's needs to stay a little bit tighter with her boxing defense.
2 minutes in the opening round. Another spinning back kick attempt from Lin Heqin. And back to the center of the circle. Been an exciting first round here tonight to open up this fight card.
Zamboanga looks a little more hesitant to pull the trigger with that right hand after that last exchange.
Yeah, Lin Heqin landed that short, tight right hand right as Zamboanga was trying to close that distance. And she got caught. And she got caught again with the left hand.
Lin Heqin left to the face of Zamboanga. Zamboanga comes right back in for more with a little bit of a flurry.
This is a really important matchup for the top five of our atomweight division. Zamboanga is defending that number three spot. And Lin Heqin wants nothing more than to work her way back into the top five. And this would be a huge milestone for if she can do so.
Biggest opportunity of her career. Overhand right from Heqin. Heqin off the loss against Itsuki Hirata said she was trying to make it too exciting as opposed to just winning the fight as they trade back and forth.
Zamboanga does good when she starts putting punches in combinations. When she disguises that right hand with the jab, she's able to touch her. But when she just throws the right hand blind, Lin Heqin has a good beat on it and is able to evade.
You know, Lin Heqin has made a couple adjustments here because she's been able to evade a lot of these punches from Zamboanga. But keep in mind, Zamboanga has a one-inch reach advantage, but Heqin is the taller opponent here by several inches.
Yeah, it's interesting. Heqin told us she felt she had the reach advantage, even though technically she's an inch down. Spinning back kick. Again, can't land it, and then took some shots on the way out. Trying some of those outside leg kicks and landed the left straight to the face of Zamboanga. Final 10 seconds, opening round. Overhand right, Zamboanga. Another one. Good stuff to close out the round from both women. Outstanding. Heqin trying to get a huge milestone win and climb into the rankings herself.
Yeah, that was a good change of tactic right there from Lin Heqin. She threw the leg kick and then immediately got her head offline. She's got to be careful because Denice is trying to time those leg kicks to counter with that right hand. So it'd be good for Lin Heqin to start working her way high up into the head as well with those kicks.
1-2 from Zamboanga, and then another as she touches the face of Heqin a couple of times. Overhand right, Zamboanga. And the outside leg kick. Good combinations here. Zamboanga in the opening minute, second round.
Zamboanga's throwing heat with that right hand now. I like how she's mixing in the leg kicks, though, giving her something to think about. I wouldn't mind seeing Denise go to the body as well with the hands.
Turn her back, Heqin on retreat, and now she gets aggressive and walks Zamboanga back down.
Yeah, that's where Zamboanga's got to be careful coming in like that, a little hasty, because she'll get caught coming in. Heqin, even though she spun off there with her leg being caught, she's dangerous.
Yeah, Denise is a little bit overextended. She's reaching with that right hand. But it's working. You can see by the damage that's starting to develop on the side of Lin Heqin's left face.
She had some of that when the round started. It's gotten progressively worse. Overhand right, and then the straight right. Zamboanga touches her again. She is cut. The face taking damage of Lin Heqin here. 2 minutes into round two.
Zamboanga's kind of abandoned her corner's advice, going straight, hook, straight, and she's landing that 1-2, just like a trip hammer.
It would be good for her to actually start feinting the jab more with a committed fashion, double jabs, triple jabs, before she actually throws that two, so that she can close that distance without having to take any of that damage coming in.
Outside, leg kick, Heqin. Tried to go up top, couldn't land it. Midway in round two, midway point of the fight.
Ooh.
Touched her again, overhand
nice.
Right, Zamboanga.
She's also got a sneaky little jab, the way she's ducking underneath it, and she's leaning her head a little bit to her right, though.
Heavy rights, Zamboanga, cutting off the angles. Doing exactly what she wants here.
Yeah, a lot of pressure. She's not just following her around the circle. She's cutting those angles, trapping her right up against the wall. She's gonna land that right hand.
Blood coming down the left side of the face and the cheek of Heqin.
I like these outside leg kicks that Zamboanga's throwing, but she needs to be careful, make sure she's getting her head offline when she's doing that, because Heqin will come back down with that right hand.
Seconds, round two. Couple of women willing to just stand and strike.
Yeah, Denice always, well, at least for the past two rounds, she started real heavy. There's that spinning back kick, and that one was actually one that landed. Denice kind of takes her foot off on the gas on the second half of the round. I'd like to see her just keep that pressure on, because if she keeps this on, she could finish this fight. But she's letting Lin Heqin work her way back in by getting these touches.
Outside leg kick, then the push kick. The sauna spinning back kick. Heqin showing all of her arsenal here as we get into the final stages of round two.
You see Heqin at this point is doing a better job of either coming forward and pushing Denice back and not allowing her to get backed up to the cage, the circle, angling off, so that she's not just backing straight up, taking that damage from those 1-2s that Zamboanga was throwing at the beginning of the first round.
You can see Denice is a little bit marked up on her lead leg, but that damage that's accumulating on the side of Lin Heqin's face is gonna be the highest scoring category so far, at least this matchup.
Final 10 seconds of round two. On the attack, Heqin. As they go into the clinch to close out the second round.
We're looking at who has done the most work over the course of this fight. And right now, based on the damage that's accumulating on the side of Lin Heqin's face, you've got to give it to Denice Zamboanga. But Lin Heqin is still dangerous, and she can put you out.
Zamboanga, to your point at the end of round two, does have some damage, you see, high on the left leg. Outside leg kick, Zamboanga.
Even though we may believe that Zamboanga's ahead on the scorecard, this fight's close enough that it's still anybody's fight. And if I was in Zamboanga's corner coaching her, I would not take my foot off the gas pedal at this point.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of urgency coming from Lin Heqin right now. I think her and her corner believe that she's behind, and she really has to make a push in these final 4 minutes.
Inside leg kick, Heqin. And another. And that one might have caught her, Zamboanga. Now they're going to keep it going. Justin Brown says, let's fight. 4 minutes to go in the bout.
Yeah, all these touches, all these leg kicks are scoring right now, and Denice is kind of getting, there's another right hand. She's got to push.
To the face, Zamboanga.
Then Heqin landed one of her own.
That's right. Heqin trying to stop this takedown. Firing rights to the head of Zamboanga.
There's that wrestling defense that you spoke about, Rich. That was beautifully done.
Yeah, she is top heavy, but I'll tell you, Denice did a great job of scrambling there instead of getting pinned underneath her.
It's those wild flurries where you can see Lin Heqin's just got that little touch and she could change her mind real quick. And then you could see that Denice started to wrestle. And then Lin Heqin just did a beautiful job of stopping it and then pressing Zamboanga up against the wall.
I'm not sure that this is something Zamboanga planned to be in that situation, with Heqin having her press against the wall.
Three to go in the fight. Back to the center of the one circle.
See a welt starting to develop on the side of Denice Zamboanga's face from the lead hand damage caused from Lin Heqin. That hook is really nice, really well timed.
I feel like there needs to be a sense of urgency here for Heqin in the final 2.5.
I might call that a bit more than a welt.
Yeah, that's a severe mouse that's developing right now on Zamboanga's right side. Rich, how do you think this damage is going to score for these two right now?
You know, I'm just sitting here thinking about that, Mitch, because we're starting to see some more damage on Denice Zamboanga's face. And if we did believe that Denice had the lead at the end of the second round, it's like Heqin now has actually started to close that distance. But one thing we got to keep in mind is the takedown defense of Heqin, and I think that's something that I haven't been accounting for. As this fight has been progressing in the scoring category, she's been able to pretty much dictate where this fight's been the entire time.
Another leg kick landed by Lin Heqin, moves to the body. I like this game. She's staying just out of range of Denice, and she's touching her over and over again, but somebody's got to pull the trigger right now. Now it's time to go. You got 90 seconds left in this match, and it's anybody's game at this point.
Snipping some jabs there. Zamboanga, outside leg kick. Heqin went to the body that time.
Yeah, that was a nice little combo. Go leg, go body.
Yeah, if I was in the corner of either of these two ladies right now, I would be telling them to put their foot down on this gas pedal and start pressing. Because this could be anybody's fight.
Final minute, opening fight of the night here in Manila.
Nice.
Good combination of Zamboanga.
That was beautiful.
Good three-piece combination right there. Zamboanga came and Heqin landed a lead hook of her own.
The crowd loving Zamboanga from right here in the Philippines.
I tell you, these ladies are not making the judges' jobs easy at the beginning of the night already.
Oh, to the side of the face that time of Heqin. She comes back with an overhand right. 25 seconds to go.
I'm expecting to see Denice take off here with that final sprint. This could come down to who lands this last combination.
Heqin shoves her to the fence. 10 seconds. How the opening fight of the night comes.
Denice!